Good morning to all of you. Today in this class we will study about concrete mixed design using available computer software packages. For any subject we must study the basics at the beginning very briefly. So we will have a brief review about the concrete technology in brief before proceeding to the actual mixed designs. So, what is the basics? Concrete is a versatile and most widely used man-made material. We can define it also. Definition: it is a mixture of water, cement, sand, and coarse aggregates. As you know very well, concrete is a versatile building material which has replaced the old traditional building materials like timber and stone masonry for few structures for last 150 years. We have a basic advantage of concrete, that is, it is possible to tailor the desired properties of concrete to meet the required demands of any particular situation. It means concrete can be made to get any desired strength irrespective of the individual material's properties. With this advantage we can make concrete as strengthy as possible. What are the ingredients of concrete? Cement is a binder. Coarse aggregate, it gives volume and solidity to the concrete. It occupies 75% of volume of the concrete. Next, sand, it is a filler. Water, it is a lubricant and a reagent. Admixtures to modify properties of concrete. Out of all these various building materials, cement is the main material binder, and coarse aggregate, it gives strength and volume and solidity for the concrete. It occupies more volume. Sand is a filler. Here onwards we call sand as a coarse fine aggregate, and coarse aggregate is nothing but like a hard blue granite strips. Water is nothing but like a ordinary potable water. Admixtures. This admixture is also nowadays defined as another component of the concrete, because this plays a vital role in modifying the properties of concrete. How to designate a concrete? As we have our names and pin code numbers, like that concrete also has its pin code number like such, that is its characteristic compressive strength. So concrete is characterized by its compressive strength only among many other properties. The 28 days compressive strength of concrete is set as index of its overall quality. So concrete compressive strength is predominant when compared to other properties like tensile strength, shear, toughness, hardness, like such. Out of all, the 28 days compressive strength is designated as the concrete's patent strength. So it is also called characteristic compressive strength. Now let us see the properties of concrete. Concrete properties are studied at two stages. One, at green stage, it is workability. Two, at hardened stage, it is strength and durability. So workability is the most important parameter which gives fluidity for the mix, and at hardened stage, strength and durability. What is durability? It is the acceptance of concrete to sustain all sorts of the atmospheric effects. Now grades of concrete, let us go for this. Grade of concrete is defined as its characteristic compressive strength at 28 days CS. It is expressed, for example, say M20, where M stands for the mix and the number 20 stands for the compressive strength at 28 dSi in newtons per millimeter square. We got different grades of concrete, because as you said, concrete is a man-made material, we can tailor any desired property. Therefore, the following grades of concrete are being produced in various construction fields in India. Plain and cement concrete M10 and M15, reinforced cement concrete it is M20 to M80. So, plain cement concrete, in earlier IS codes like IS 456, the minimum grade of concrete for plain concrete is said to be M10 and for RCC M15. Now, it is totally changed. So, from durability considerations, the minimum grade of concrete for plain is restricted to M15 and for RCC it is M20. We can go up to M80 in our country within our practical constraints. Classification of concrete mixes. So, based on the performance of concrete, concrete mixes can be broadly classified as nominal mix concrete or ordinary concrete, and design mix concrete, also called controlled concrete. These two are the most important parameters in the concrete mix design. So, ordinary concrete, for all our routine general building constructions wherein below M20 grade concrete is used, some arbitrary design mixes can be used as suggested by IS standards. And for major works, for all works more than M20 grade concrete, we have to go for a controlled concrete, also called designed concrete. Design mix concrete, this is our concept today. As per the strength requirements, and concrete can be classified as ordinary concrete, these grades are M10, M15 and M20. Standard concrete M25 to M55, high strength concretes M60 to M80, and we can use up to M20 as ordinary concrete, and we can depend upon the arbitrary proportions also if not possible to design. Standard concrete M25 to M55 is called a standard concrete. We have to compulsorily perform mixed design following some principles. And high strength concrete M60 to M80. In our country, our codal provisions are restricting the use up to M55 within the normal usage of our available materials. If you want to go for high strength concretes, we have to compulsorily depend on certain additions like admixtures. Now, design of concrete mix, how we can define this concept? It is to determine the proportions of concrete ingredients for the required strength and workability. The words are too important, strength and workability. Workability is initial stage and strength is at the final stage. If initial stage workability is not achieved, there is no meaning to get strength in this ultimate stage. What are the various factors affecting the design of concrete mix? One is grade of concrete, it is a primary requirement, and the type of cement. Then maximum nominal size of aggregates, water cement ratio, workability, minimum and maximum cement content, durability of concrete. We will see one by one briefly. Grade of concrete, it is the strength what we require, and the type of cement, we got different types of cements, not on the brand names but on the grades. The compressive strength of cement at 7-day strength and 28-day strength, accordingly we got 33 grade cement, 43 grade cement and 53 grade cements. And nowadays blended cements are also coming, that is called the pozzolanic cements using fly ash as an internal admixture. Maximum nominal size of aggregate, this maximum size of aggregate, that depends upon the thickness of the member what we go on constructing. If you go for the higher size, definitely strength of the aggregate is more and concrete strength will increase, but other properties like voids, content will be increasing. Water cement ratio, it is the most important heart for the entire mixed design. Water cement ratio, now it is predefined as water binder ratio, more appropriately water binder, because cement today we are calling it binder, but now today research work is going on to replace cement also. So, instead of using cement word, binder is now being used. So, weight of water to weight of cement, it is called water cement ratio. This water cement ratio is governing the strength of cement. As per Abraham's law, we study water cement ratio is the only factor which influences the strength of a workable concrete. Then workability, the name itself indicates, it is the easiness with which we can make all concreting operations. Concreting operations means collection of materials and proportionating, mixing, transporting, placement, compaction, finishing and curing. All these things can be easily conducted by having a term called workability. it is nothing but the fluidity of concrete. Minimum and maximum cement content, see here, minimum cement content, and we design a concrete mix, we will get some result like some quantity of cement that must be checked from the minimum requirement from durability considerations. And maximum cement content also is there, because when we manufacture cement, automatically large quantity of carbon dioxide gases are liberated in the atmosphere and polluting the entire environment. Therefore, government insists on the use of the cement content also. So, if we want to design for high strength concretes also, we will get definitely more quantity of cement, but we have to restrict it to 450 kgs per meter cube. Then how to get a good strength, we have to depend on some other admixtures and blended cements like this. We will discuss this point again at the flag end of it. Durability of concrete, durability means the overall stability of the concrete. It is the total responsibility of the concrete, it is a good response against all atmospheric effects like freezing and thawing, high temperatures, cold temperatures and water activity, acidic activities, corrosive atmosphere, like in all the atmospheric effects are acting on the structures, the structure should withstand, that property is called durability. Now, methods of concrete mix design, we got ever number of methods, so we can list out here. IS code method as per IS SP 23, special publication number 23 is meant for design of concrete mixes. ACA method, American Concrete Institute's method, USBR mixed design method, the British method, maximum density method, minimum voids method, fineness modulus method, and IS code method of mixed design, this is our objective. And ever we design many methods, but to avoid a confusion, to have a unified procedure throughout the country as a whole, the Bureau of Indian Standards with a set of experts has formulated certain principles and evolved out this concept IS code method of mixed design. So, in this mixed design, we require certain data. What data we require it is? First, strength and workability of concrete. We have to fix up what strength we want it first and what workability we want it. These parameters again depend on many other things. Physical properties of all ingredients like density, specific gravity, water absorption, moisture content, size and shape of aggregates, water and percentage sand requirements, grading, etc. Now, strength and workability requirements, how do you go for this? For example, you can see selection of water cement ratio. So, the strength of concrete depends on the water cement ratio. The water cement ratio is tabulated having the experimental results done earlier in various research laboratories. So, you can see FCK, characteristic compressive strength here now from 10 to 60, and this is obtained from the figure 46 of SP 23 handbook. Generalized value is given here, water cement ratio, the FCK versus water cement ratio graph will be given, from that we can interpolate all these values for 10.63, 15.63 like that up to 60.3. We can take out whatever strength we wanted corresponding water cement ratio we can pick out. Now, this is a generalized form given earlier. Nowadays, we got the different varieties of cements like 33 grade cement, 43 grade cement and 53 grade cements. Accordingly, the effect of grade of cement is not much on the low strength concretes, but when you go for high strength concretes here, the effect of grade is much more it is. So, it is say grade 33 grade you can take, for example, for M40 it is 0.3 water cement ratio required right now. Same thing 43 grade cement you wanted, M0.36, and same thing for 0.43. So, when you go for high grade cements, the ratio is increasing, it means the cement consumption is reduced. We can use economically the cement consumption. So, that is the advantage of going for high grade cements. There are certain restrictions also in this, we will discuss later. Now, let us go for the physical properties of all ingredients like density, specific gravity, water absorption, moisture content, size, shape of aggregates, water content and grading, etc. So, these parameters we can conduct in laboratory and get the results, and moisture content, size and shape. Size and shape it is, size of aggregate is nothing but whether it is a 20 mm size aggregate, 10 mm size aggregate like this. Shape of aggregates, we have got two shapes, angular shapes and rounded aggregates. Now, the required data will continue it. Degree of quality control and standard deviation. The grade of concrete, whatever we want to select, again depends upon the degree of quality control. In different sites, we got different degrees of quality controls. What are those it is? We got see very good quality control and fair quality control. What this table says, from SP 23 table, table 39 says suggested values of standard deviation. This most important parameter required. Standard deviation is nothing but a statistical value to obtain the compressive strength of concrete in newtons per millimeter square units for different grades of concrete. Say you take M20, it is. If exposure is very good, 3.6 value or 4.6 value for good condition and 5.6 value for the fair exposure conditions, we can select it. Now, secondly, the exposure conditions. What are the various exposure conditions? Depending upon the severity and the environment and its effects, we got the 5 different exposure conditions. What are those? It is. See exposure conditions as per IS 456. Environment and exposure conditions. First, mild atmosphere. Members protected against weather or aggressive conditions except in coastal areas. Moderate, members in underwater conditions and in coastal areas under sheltered conditions. Then severe, members exposed to severe rain and alternate wetting and drying. Very severe, members exposed to corrosive and very aggressive environment. Extreme, members in tidal zone and in contact with aggressive chemicals. Suppose we are in a severe condition, for example, even though we want to design M20 grade concrete, but the durability conditions insists on use of minimum M30 grade concrete. So, selection of grade of concrete is not in our hand as you like. The durability and exposure conditions will dictate terms how to select the water cement ratio and grade of concretes. We will go further. Design stipulations. Certain standard data is required for design. It is called design stipulations. What are these? Characteristic compressive strength of concrete, we select it depending upon the durability considerations and exposure conditions. Then target main strength, what this target is. As you study earlier, we got different quality control conditions like good, bad and very good like this. And depending upon these conditions, we will have this target main strength. What is the target main strength? This is the strength for which we have to design the mix in laboratories, because field conditions are entirely different to laboratory conditions. If you want at least 20 strength in field, we should design for more value in the laboratory, and the remaining balance is offset for want of all these atmospheric effects. So, this difference will be depending upon the degree of quality control. So, target mean strength can be calculated. Maximum size of aggregate, degree of workability also it is given in terms of the slump value or compaction factor value, like very high and low or medium or very low like this. The degree of quality control as we said now, and type of exposures. Now, target mean strength, how do you define target mean strength? It is the compressive strength for which the mix is designed considering the various design stipulations. Design procedure, we will go for the design procedure one by one, after that we will perform one design. First, select the grade of concrete based on the strength requirement and environmental exposure conditions. So, first we select the grade requirement, and from strength we want suppose M20, okay, M20 we can select it now. Then water cement ratio also we can select it depending upon our grade of cement. Our grade of cement suppose you use 43 grade cement, then for M20 we can select 0.62 as a water cement ratio. Then next one, we take the exposure conditions. Just now we studied the exposure conditions, all these conditions are there. We select to which condition we belong, our area belongs. Suppose you construct a seashore area, then we can take very severe. Inside the sea we can take extreme conditions. Then we can go for the other things, that is the minimum cement content and maximum water cement ratio and minimum grade of concrete under specified conditions of exposure. This is given in table 5 of IS 456 2000. So, for reinforced concrete exposure it is, suppose if we take mild exposure, minimum cement content shall be 300 and maximum water cement ratio 0.55 and minimum grade of concrete is M20. You go for example, extreme conditions, even though we want to design M20, but code specifies minimum grade shall be M40 irrespective of the type of structure. So, this must be compulsorily followed, here it is. Then we go for next item, that is the second point of design procedure. First you select the concrete mixed design, grade of concrete, then arrive at the target mean strength from the characteristic compressive strength and level of quality control. Ft is equal to Fck plus K into S, where K is equal to a statistical value, it is taken as 1.65. This value depends upon the definition of characteristic compressive strength. So, S stands for a standard deviation. So, corresponding to the grade of concrete and degree of quality control, and we can take out the standard deviation. The standard deviation we can take out as you studied, depending on degree of quality control for M20 concrete and good quality control you can take 4.6, or fail it is 5.6 and very good it is 3.6. Then once you find out the target mean strength FT, the next step is we have to select the water cement ratio for the target mean strength and check it against limiting water cement ratio. So water cement ratio, as you studied, we have to check up here now. From this water cement ratio for this particular grade here now for M20, we have to calculate target strength FT. FT will be, for example, 30. For 30 corresponding to this one, it is equal to 0.45 water cement ratio equal to. Then accordingly you can take 0.45. This must be again checked from the minimum requirements. Select the water quantity required corresponding to the maximum size of aggregate and workability requirements. And select the absolute volume of sand in total aggregate from tables 42 and 43 of ISSP 23. Here there are certain tables. ISSP 23 has given this procedure outlines very, very clearly and self-explanatory. First, once you fix up the target strength and water cement ratio, then you go for this table wherein the approximate sand and water content per meter cube of concrete, this is given for water cement ratio 0.6 and workability of 0.8 in CF compaction factor. This is applicable to concrete grade up to M35 only. For M35 and above, we have to use separate table. In this, what is given? Maximum size of aggregate given 10, 20, 40. Water content in meter cube of concrete, so many kgs per meter cube of concrete. Sand, we know it is into a number of zones, zone 1, zone 2, zone 3, zone 4. Sand is divided by sieve analysis. So standard sand is taken as zone 2. So sand as a percent of total aggregate by absolute volume. These data can be directly taken. For example, our aggregate size is 20 mm, water quantity can take 186 and the sand content is equal to 35. Suppose if you use a grade of concrete more than M35, then you can go for the second table. That is for applicable to concrete above 35 grade concrete, same parameters. Our water cement ratio 0.35 and workability 0.8. But here this table gives the values for this fixed value of water cement ratio 0.35 and compaction factor. But our values are not fixed. We will get some other values. Then we have to make adjustments for the difference of the water cement ratio and compaction factors. We will see it later. So for 20 mm aggregate, 180 liters we can take out like this. So once you find out the water cement content, water cement ratio and water quantity and sand quantity, in 1 cubic meter of concrete, we got ingredients like cement, sand, water and coarse aggregates. Out of all these, cement quantity we know and water quantity we know, sand quantity we know, then the coarse aggregate quantity only we have to find out. We have to see. Carry out the adjustments in water and percent of sand content for other conditions of workability, grading of aggregates, water cement ratio, size and shape of aggregates as per the table numbers 44 of SP 23. What this? This table gives here adjustments in various values of water content and percent of sand for other conditions. Change in condition. For example, in the table, the sand is taken as grading zone 2. If our sand is grading zone 1, for example, then we can make adjustments for gradings for sand conforming to other zones. Grading zone 1, it is plus 1.5. Our sand is, suppose grading zone 3, minus 1.5%. Our sand is grading zone 4, minus 3%. In the water content, there is no change. Similarly, the water cement ratio, increase or decrease in the values of the water cement ratios and compaction factors by 0.1. So compaction factor means workability it is. Our compaction factor value is specified as 0.8 in the table, but our value may be 0.9. For difference value, we can take. If plus difference is there, 3%, minus difference is there, minus 3% in water quantity. In sand quantity, 0, no change required. Similarly, other conditions, the each 0.05 increase or decrease in water cement ratio, there is no change in water content and sand content change is there, plus 1% or minus 1%. And aggregate shape for rounded aggregates, minus 15, so many kgs per cubic meters in water quantity and in sand quantity, minus 1%. For angular aggregate is there, no change in any parameter. Now this is the fifth step. After making the adjustments, then we have to calculate the total water content and percentage of sand content after making all necessary adjustments. Then we calculate the cement content from water cement ratio and total water quantity requirement. And water by cement ratio we know and water quantity we know, we can calculate cement quantity. Check the cement content again for minimum requirements for durability considerations. Suppose you got cement of some 300 kgs, then we have to go for checkup of our exposure conditions. Suppose moderate conditions there now, minimum cement content is 300, it's okay. Our exposure is suppose extreme, our cement is 360 minimum. Even though we got 300 kgs, we have to provide compressor 360 kgs. So this we have to go and check up. Once the cement content is checked and provide the correct values, then next step is calculate the net absolute volume of concrete per 1 cubic meter by subtracting the volume of entrapped air for the given maximum size of aggregates. In concrete, when you mix up here, air is entrapped automatically. So, air entrapment, how much quantity? That depends upon the maximum size of aggregate. We can see here now, approximate entrapped air content, maximum size of aggregate 10, 20, 40 is there. Entrapped air is percent of volume of concrete. For 10 mm aggregates, it may be 3%, for 20 mm size it is 2%, and 40 mm size it is 1%. Sometimes we may intentionally entrap air also, it is called air entrained concrete, that is separate concept. So, in this year, if our aggregate is 20 mm, we can take 2% as the air. If we design 1 cubic meter of concrete, in that 2% means 0.02 cubic meters of air. So, net volume of the concrete is 1 minus 0.02 is equal to 0.98. So, we are designing concrete mix means for 0.98 cubic meters only, we have to design all the ingredients. Then, once the volume is calculated correctly, then we have to find out lastly the one item, that is how much quantity of sand and coarse aggregate in kgs. That is, see here, knowing the absolute volume of fresh concrete, it is called V. The absolute volumes of coarse and fine aggregates can be found from the following equations. It is V into 1000 is equal to W plus C by SC plus FA by P into SFA. Similarly, V into 1000 is equal to W plus C by SC plus FA by 1 minus P into SCA. What are the parameters? V is equal to our net absolute volume of concrete, that is 0.98 cubic meters. W is equal to, it is weight of water in kgs we have selected. Then C is equal to total weight of cement we can calculate. Then SC is equal to, it is specific gravity of the cement. These parameters we can see in this. V is equal to absolute volume of concrete, SC is equal to specific gravity of cement, W is equal to weight of water in kgs per meter cube of concrete, and C is equal to weight of cement in kgs per meter cube of concrete, and P is equal to ratio of fine aggregate to total aggregate. This ratio we have selected from the tables, and F suffix small a is equal to weight of fine aggregate. This quantity we are calculating now, and CA is equal to weight of coarse aggregate. SFA and SCA are specific gravities of fine and coarse aggregates. This we can determine in laboratories. Now, once you find out all the parameters and calculate the correct values of sand quantity and coarse aggregate quantities, then arrange the calculated weights of all ingredients in kgs in the following order. Water quantity 180 liters is an example I have taken. Cement is 360 kgs and fine aggregate is 720 kgs and coarse aggregate is 1440 kgs. Now, if you want to get in a proportion, divide all the items by weight of cement. Take weight of cement always as unity. So, obtain the proportions by dividing the values of all items with that of cement. So, water 180 by 360 gives 0.5 is the water cement ratio. 1 part of cement is to 2 parts of fine aggregate and 4 parts of coarse aggregate. It is an example, we may get this figure or any other odd figures also. Now, final adjustments, this is not the end of design. Final adjustments means, you know, the aggregates in field they contain some moisture content and water absorptions. Those are to be taken into account. We see here what are the final adjustments. Make necessary adjustments for the following items. Deduct from the water content for free moisture present in the sand. Add extra quantity of sand for loss due to the free moisture. Add extra water for water absorption of the coarse aggregates. Water absorption by coarse aggregates. Deduct from the coarse aggregate quantity for its water absorption. So, take the proportions obtained in weights. If you want to calculate these weights proportions and again volumetric proportions, then you can make a small procedure. Here it is. So, water quantity is 180 liters, previous results, cement quantity 360, fine aggregate quantity 720 and coarse aggregate 1440. Divide all the above values by the respective bulk density values and arrange them in proportions again. So, why should we do like this one? In our construction fields, in suburban areas or urban areas, in villages also, we have to compulsorily face a problem of volumetric units only being implemented. So, we have to convert them into volumetric units. Our design results are obtained in weights. So, volumetric proportions. So, bulk density cement you can take 1440 kgs per meter cube, and bulk density fine aggregate you can take 1700 kgs per meter cube, and bulk density of coarse aggregate you can take 1600 kgs per meter cube. These values are not standards, we have to test them, there are only some empirical figures. And the proportions now become water quantity, divide all these things by bulk densities. So, 360 by 1440, 720 by 1700, 1440 by 1600. Then we will get a 0.5 here as usually, 1 is to 1.7 is to 3.4. So 1:1.3.4 by volume, 1:4 by weights. For weights, weighing machines and everything are required, they may not be available in every sites. So in such cases, it is nothing wrong in converting these ratios. Now let us go and see how this can be designed in packages. There are no ready-made packages actually, we have to make a packages. See here computerized designs. The descriptive method of concrete mixed design can be computerized in either Visual Basic or in MS Excel. The mixed designs carried out in both the above two formats are now presented here. So we have the, before going for conclusions, we can go for this mixed design as we can see in this Excel format. It is very easier. There are no standard packages, ready-made packages available on the concrete mixed design as we have in our other type of the usages. Design of concrete mix as per ISSP 23/1982 and IS 4 Physics 2000. Design stipulations, we can give here concrete designation. Now these blue color fields only are to be filled up here, remaining cells shall not be changed. So suppose you want to have a design of concrete mix. If you want to design M25 grade concrete, keep M25 here, or if you want to have M30 grade concrete, type M30 it is, like this, anything. Now maximum size of core stair gate, our maximum size of core stair gate is for example 20 mm size, we have typed already 20 mm, here it is 20. Then shape of the aggregates, there are two shapes, round aggregates and angular aggregates, I put here angular aggregates. Then degree of workability, very low and low, medium and high. Suppose you have taken medium corresponding to the slump values. Then compaction factor, our compaction factor is equal to 0.92 for example it is. Then environmental exposure conditions, as you see now from durability aspects, mild, moderate, severe, very severe and extreme. You type here mild, even you can type also it is moderate. Then what type of concrete you are designing, is it PCC concrete or RCC concrete? Normally for RCC only make design, so type RCC. So what is the minimum grade of concrete required from durability considerations? Because you have taken it as moderate condition, we got it M25. For example, we have taken here now for example extreme, automatically minimum grade of concrete is M40, but while we selected here now in this initial stage M30 wanted to design, but extreme conditions will not be designed by M40, so we get a message here not okay, change the grade of concrete as per minimum requirements. So we have to go for here and change minimum must be M20. Like this we can make the requirements of durability in the initial stage itself. Then go for this degree of quality control, we got very good control or fair control. Suppose very good control you have it now. Then grade of cement used, 53 grade or 33 grade or 43 grade. Normally when we take a high strength concretes, it is obvious we have to go for the high grade cement, so 53 grade cement. Then grading zone, sand, we have a grading zone 1, 2, 3 or 4, or this code has been standardized with a grading zone 2. If our sand is grading zone 3, we can make adjustments as you study just now. So grading zone is 3, this is from the laboratory results we can obtain. These are the mechanical properties and physical properties of the aggregates. Specific rate of coarse aggregate 2.6, specific rate of fine aggregate it is again 2.6, specific rate of cement 3.15, and specific rate of cement it is varying factor, whether you are using the slag cement or blended cements or a OPC ordinary Portland cement. For ordinary Portland cement will have a figures from 3.1 to 3.15, for a slag cement or any Portland pozzolanic cements the values will be around 3.0 to 3.1. So the water absorption of coarse aggregates 0.5%, water absorption of fine aggregate it is again 1%. Then free moisture content in coarse aggregate, suppose there is no percent, 0%, you can have also some 2% also, sometimes you can add anything, whatever data we have you can fill up here. Absorb moisture in coarse aggregate, water moisture absorption, and free moisture in coarse fine aggregate again. Then these are the total data feeding, once data is over then automatically it gets the values. These parameters are the calculated values directly obtained from this package. Suggested value standard deviation, it is 5.6. For the extreme conditions, very good conditions of the quality control and extreme atmospheric conditions, for grade of concrete M40, we have selected the value is equal to, this is 5.6. Then target mean strength, we have got the formula also on target mean strength, that is FT is equal to FC plus K into S. So with the formula application, we got this one it is. Then water cement ratio required for target strength by interpolation. Here actually water cement ratio we can get it for different values. We our design concrete is M40 grade. So for 40 and 45 and 50 we can take the figures. Because our target strength is 49.24. For 45, what is the value of this? And 50, what is the value of this? From these two interpolate, the interpolate value of water cement ratio is taken as 0.36 here. This is from the figure 47 of SP23. Reference is given here. Then maximum value of water cement ratio for extreme conditions. Our water cement ratio obtained is 0.36. Under no case it shall exceed 0.4. So it is within the limits. Okay. Then water content including surface water in kgs per meter cube of concrete. How much quantity? This I told you in the table of 42 and 43, and we have selected depending upon the size of the coarse aggregates, and that is given as 190 liters. So this is only the free water. Our sand, it is sand zone, sand content as percent of total aggregate with absolute volume. So this quantity can be taken as equal to 23, because we have to use second table, our grade is more than M35 it is. Then adjustments required. Now the adjustments in water content, adjustments in sand in total quantity of aggregates. For water cement ratio 0.36, there is no adjustment here, but sand, our sand is grading zone 3, but sand is grading zone 2 as per standards, the difference is made up here now. Then for sand conformity grading zone 3, this is the adjustment of minus 1.5%, and for compaction factor 0.92, adjustments are 3.6% water quantity adjustment and 0 adjustment in the sand quantities. And then for angular shape of aggregates, there is no adjustment. If our aggregate is rounded, for example, then definitely we would have some corrections. Then for both the angular shape of aggregates, both the aggregates, then total quantity of water changes and fine aggregate changes are put here now. Now required sand content as percent of total aggregate by absolute volume. So from the previous value we can make adjustments, net value is given as 21.7% it is. Now required water quantity 196.34, we have selected 190 liters here now in the previous column, and all the adjustments are coming down to 6.84 extra, and 196.84 liters are now required. Cement requirement, from the water cement ratio and water quantity, cement quantity can be calculated as 547 kgs per meter cube. This figure is the highest figure. Now we will make the decision like this one. Minimum quantity of cement shall be checked from exposure conditions, that is 360 kgs, just now I shown the table it is. Then adjustments to minimum cement quantity for 20 ohm size aggregates, no adjustments. Suppose if you use the 10 ohm aggregates or 40 ohm aggregates, we will have to add or reduct the cement quantity also. Then minimum quantity of cement required for M40 exposure conditions, it is 360. Therefore, what is the cement quantity we have to provide? The cement quantity what we have to provide is that 547 kgs. Then volume of the concrete materials, concreting materials, net quantity of concrete is equal to 0.98. I told you 1 minus 0.02 is the entrapped air volume, is equal to 0.98 absolute volume of concrete. In this, fine aggregate quantity is equal to 343.89 kgs, and absolute volume of coarse aggregate is equal to, they are all weights it is. And say this is the volume of coarse aggregate is equal to 78.3, and weight of coarse aggregate is given as 1240 kgs around. And therefore, fine aggregate quantity 342.89 kgs and coarse aggregate quantity is 1240.84 kgs. Now we can make out here now proportions. Water quantity 196.84 kgs, cement is equal to 547, fine aggregate is equal to 343 and odd kgs, and coarse aggregate is equal to 1249. So I told you now divide all these things by weight of the cement quantity, we got water cement ratio 0.36, 1:2 and 0.63:2.27. Now these are the general proportions. We can make out the proportions for one bag of cement also, it is customary in every sites. So for one bag of cement, 18 liters of water is required here, one bag of cement 50 kgs, and this is 31.5 kgs of sand, and remaining quantity of sand it is given, coarse aggregate. Then the coarse aggregate quantity may be having a two size fractions also, it is 120 ohm size some portion and 10 ohm size some portions. Then the fractions can be also divided as 60 and 40 ratios. Note here, as per the class 8.2.42 of IS 456, maximum cement content is limited to 450 kgs for any grade of concrete. To get the required strength, addition of mineral admixtures like silica fume, fly ash, etc. shall be resorted to. I told you here now, we got the cement quantity as high as equal to nearly some 547 kgs we require cement quantity. So 547 kgs cement quantity is more than 450, so we have to restrict it to 450 only, and the trial cast mix must be cast. And then we have to make a number of trials using the mineral mixers like silica fume, fly ash, or this rice husk ashes, like such, and other admixtures, and try in a different way to get the required strength. So this is the generalized concept here. Now let us change here the parameters. Suppose if you want to have the exposure conditions, change the exposure conditions it is. Instead of extreme here now, you selected some mild condition it is. In mild condition it is, we can simply here now the grade of concrete, minimum grade of concrete required is also given here now. M20 itself it is. So, we can make out, need not have M40, we can take out here now 20 even. In 20 also put here now, now you will give a message also, okay, proceed with the design. So, that now you can make all the adjustments from durability aspects in this above the cells and finally, you can proceed design here now. And the degree of quality control also, we can keep here good only itself, not very good. Generally, good is taken it is. Then cement grade also, suppose you take a 33 grade cement for example it is. Then automatically the proportions are, remaining parameters let us keep same thing like specific gravity everything and the proportions also now changing it is totally required water content and 1:2 it is given as 1.01:2.41 proportions for 33 grade cement. Now you can see change the grade of cement automatically you will get a some other variety of the proportions. The grade of cement is 33, we can keep here now 43 grade of cement it is. Let us see how the variation is coming down it is. The variation is coming down here now 1:1.29:2.88. So, like this we can have this. We also have one more variety of the software that also we can plan it here that is given by the executive department. They have done this package of concrete mixed design conforming to IS 10262383, SP23 and IS 4FS 2000 on visual basic format it is. It is also a versatile product and being used by the many executive departments. See concrete grade required M20. We can change over here now any grade of concrete like M20, M25 like this. And compaction factor 0.9, we can get different values. And degree of quality control, we can see here good or average, we can take anything. Grade of cement, we can have the 33, 43 and 53 grade cements. And exposure conditions, we can have the mild, moderate, severe and very severe and extreme as we studied it is. So, take moderate for example, specific rate of aggregates, specific rate of coarse and fine aggregate, water absorption of aggregates like this data is given. And then water absorption of coarse aggregate, moisture content of an aggregate, shape of aggregates, we got again two types, angular and rounded it is. Normally angular aggregates only we use it now. Bulk loose density of aggregates, it is 1.7 or you can take generally and bulk loose density of the metal fraction 1, it is 1.6 and fraction 2, it is 1.4. This is the data and C analysis of aggregate is also given here now, fan aggregate. From this we can decide about the grading zone of sand, C analysis results of the fan aggregate. So, from this we can decide the grading zone 1 or 2 like this one it is. Then the for the coarse aggregate also the grading is given here now it is. ISCU size, fraction size 1, fraction size 2 it is. 10mm size, normally for 10mm size it shall be between 25% to 55%. We take suppose 40% in one quantity and other quantity suppose you can take another 50%. Between 25 to 55 it must be there as per IS 383 code. And 4.75 we can keep nil or something small percentage. This is not that we can keep as you like it, we have to get the required and actual test results whatever we do in laboratories. So, then once we feed up all the data here now, then we can just perform here now the system. So, once we make up all the data here now, just we will wait for 1 minute, the system gets hanging up. In the meanwhile, we can change our data also if you want it. We can take out this previous results here now and the same design mix will compare it here now. For example, you can take here now the previous one M20 grade concrete, grade of concrete is equal to M20 and then the maximum coarse aggregate 20 mm, angular, medium degree of workability and mild atmosphere like this. So, for this what is the result we got it now? The result will be like 1:1.29:2.88. Now, this can be comparable and with this other results. So, we will again try once again. These packages will be sometimes hanging up and we can make out. See, this is M20 and 0.9 and the conditions are same conditions are there and finally, we will come to the other ends. This 10mm size aggregate we just small change to 40%, here also we change to some 50%. Then we can simply perform a design mix, we got a proportion like 1:1.45:3.06. It gives the number of bags also it is 7.6 bags per 1 cubic meter of the concrete. Cement quantity is given and water quantity is given in so many liters and water cement is given as 0.46. So like this, either you can use a packages, ready-made packages. This package shall be again checked up for its versatility. So better always we can design your own package by using the Excel, so that now for any variety of the combination of the results, we can get the results and then we can test it. Simply getting the results is not the end of the designs. We have to see here now conclusions. Getting the results is not the end of it. That means we have to test the results again in laboratory by conducting controlled concrete cubes. And whatever result we got it now, we have to cast number of concrete mixes, concrete cubes, and then test them at the ages of 7 days and 28 days. If you get a result of the target strength correct in laboratories, then we can say our design is correct. That is given here. See, many methods of concrete mix designs are available. However, the basic concept to be kept in mind in any method is to arrive at a mix of minimum voids and maximum density for the given combination of workability and strength. Minimum cement content, maximum cement water cement ratio are to be controlled from the durability considerations. For environmental protection and serviceability problems of structures, an upper limit of 450 kg of cement per 1 cubic meter of concrete is imposed irrespective of grade of concrete. This is due to the fact that when high grade cement and high quantity cement is used, it creates a shrinkage stresses and shrinkage cracks on the structures which cannot be controlled. Similarly, the cement production also will liberate large quantity of carbon dioxide and pollute the environment. So, protect the environment as well as the structures also from severity of the stresses and strains, then the maximum limit is also imposed. To get the required strength, we depend upon the admixtures. For obtaining the required strength and workability in high grade concretes, the use of mineral admixtures like fly ash, condensed silica fume, etc. shall be used. Conclusions, final. After mix design is over, number of trial mixes are to be cast and tested at ages of 7 and 28 days to ascertain the validity of the design proportions. So, unless you do it now, our mix design is not correct, because we get some proportion, the proportion needs to be 100% verified. If you do not get correct results, it does not mean the procedure is wrong. We have to make a different other materials also from other quarries and combine them. Combination of materials also may give sometimes a good results. So, I wish we can perform trial mixes with a known results in a laboratory and understand the concept of the concrete mix design. Unless you make a practice, you can't enjoy the end of the concrete mix design. Good luck to you all of you.